Hey guys, what's up? And thank you for clicking on the video. And welcome to the part 4 tutorial in your Adobe After Effects training. And in today's tutorial, people, we're going to take a look at the layers, okay, in Adobe After Effects. Alright, people, so let's get started. Now guys, you need to understand that Adobe After Effects keeps all its layers into the timeline panel, okay, which is below over here. It stretches from the left-hand side of the screen to the right-hand side of the screen, this whole broad thing, okay? It is supposed to be the timeline panel. And these different things, okay, these colored lines over here, these red colored lines, and you can see that all these different numbered things, okay, all these things, people, are supposed to be my layers, okay. Now, the layers, people, is a very big thing, okay, it's a very big subject. So therefore, guys, I'm going to split this subject into two videos, okay. This is the layers 1 video, and the next is going to be the layers 2 video, in which I, like, show you how do you, like, change the properties of the layers, okay. So that's going to help you out a lot in your project, okay. Alright, so let's focus on today's tutorial. Alright, so on the left hand side of the screen, okay, people, on the timeline, you can see that all these different things, okay, this is the place, okay, this is the part of the place, people, where you need to stack up your layers properly, alright. Like, if you people have some experience working with Adobe Photoshop, you'll understand that how important it is to stack up your layers properly for creating some very nice effects. If you take a look at this, okay, just to explain you people, if you take a look at my number 6 layer, that is a TJ style, and my number 5 layer, that is a golden light, okay, this is supposed to be a text layer, and this is supposed to be a solid layer. And if you see people, it is actually overlapping each other, alright, they're actually one top of the other, alright. So therefore guys, it's supposed to be like it is not supposed to be showing the TJ style. But sometimes guys, what happens is, you need to actually have these layers on top of another, so that you can have some very nice effects. For example, if I go to the left hand side of the timeline, okay, extreme left, you can take a look that there are this eyeball icons, alright. If I remove the eyeball, right, this icon, if I check it out, you'll see that the effect, alright, or this layer, the visibility of the layer, just goes away, and you can see that how dull my text looks and the whole background looks without that layer, right? If I put the ball in again, you can see that the effect and the visibility of the layer just comes back. So that's a very good thing. Alright, we'll just keep going on. And guys, now coming to the right hand part of the timeline, okay, if you take a look at these different colored lines, alright, right over here, you're gonna see that they are like they are not proper, okay, they are not proportionate, they are not like equal to one another. And this is because people, they determine the size or say that the length, the duration of the layer appearing in my project, alright. If I put that thing in simple terms, you can take a look at this thing right here, tutorials for everyone, alright. If you take a look at that, or actually guys, take a look at this layer, TJ style, alright. The CTI, that is the current time indicator, it shows me my starting frame, and it tells me guys that if I scrub along the timeline, right, and you will see that, like, yeah, this is the end of the layer, right, and if I go ahead of that, you can see that this is the very ending frame, right, the very ending frame, of the layer. And from this part, alright, the other layer, the tutorials for everyone just starts, okay. So basically, this tells me that you only have TJ style tutorial or the TJ style layer or that text only for 3 seconds and 1 frame. If you people haven't watched my part 3 tutorial, make sure that you go ahead and watch it, because I have explained some really cool things, okay, about the CTI and the time code. So if you're getting confused about what are those two things, go ahead and watch my part 3 tutorial, alright. The next thing in Adobe After Effects, what I want to show you is that firstly guys, if you people have any experience with Adobe Photoshop, alright, there is only going to be one kind of a layer. But in Adobe After Effects, people, alright, like I'm just saying, because Adobe Photoshop is a very commonly used software, alright, because most of you graphic beginners should always go ahead and start with that. I'm just saying, yeah, like if you want to go straight away jump to After Effects, that's your thing. I'm just saying, that's your decision. But in Adobe After Effects, people, there are lots of, like, there are many different kind of layers, okay. For example, I'm gonna go ahead and create a new composition just to explain you, right. I'm gonna name it layers, and I'm gonna click okay, so that, okay, and there is this white checkered board. And actually guys, it's actually good, this thing is actually gonna favor me for explaining you people what I want to explain, alright. Now if you see over here, right, it is a blank checkerboard. And you see guys that over here that there are absolutely no layers, okay, it's a blank timeline, no layers at all. If you scrub the timeline, as in you scrub the current time indicator, you cannot see anything on the program monitor because there are no layers. Alright, so let's go ahead and add a few layers, alright. For adding different layers, people, you do a right click on the blank space which is there, okay, in the timeline. You do a right click, go to new, and then guys, you can take a look at all these different things. A Photoshop, Adobe Photoshop file, the adjustment layer, shape layer, null object, camera, light, solid text. All these different things, okay? All these different things, people, are supposed to be different kind of layers. Now, since you guys are beginners, I would want to say that the most of the time which you people are going to be using is going to be the camera, the solid layer, and the text layer, and the light layer also, like, for sometimes, right? And the shape layer, guys, I don't really prefer it that much because there's an absolutely a set of tools, okay, that allows me to make my shapes, alright, on the layer itself, alright, so I can avoid a layer in my project file. therefore keeping my timeline more clean. But that's just my personal preference, okay? I can show you different techniques by which you can keep your timeline clean and organized and use so that you don't get mixed up with different things, okay? So we're going to go ahead and do a right click and create a quick composition, okay? So that you guys can have a proper understanding about layers. We're going to go to new. And guys, we're going to start with a background, alright? We're going to go ahead and do a solid layer. Now, if you see, it's going to name itself. It's going to ask for a layer. And guys, it is very, very important for you to name your layers, okay? I'm going to name it BG or standing background. And I'm going to do this button, okay, which says make comp size. So that when the layer comes, it takes up the whole space which is there in my timeline, okay? And I'm going to go ahead and change the color to black and click okay. And you can see that we have a layer now in our timeline. We have the BG. And guys, let's go ahead and do some funky thing, alright? Just to explain you people more about layers. Solid and say, actually, not solid. Go ahead, make a new text layer. And I'm going to just go and type my own name, TJ Style. And what the hell kind of font is that? It looks good, but who the hell made all these different settings and all? But anyways, I'm just going to go ahead and keep this thing good. I think I like it. Therefore, and somewhere over here. Alright, that's the thing, I'm good. Oops, yeah. And guys, this is my basic creation, okay? This is a basic startup of an intro, right? Like, I was just thinking to create an intro, but I'm not going to do that, right, for some reasons. And guys, now let's go ahead. And actually, guys, I'm just going to go ahead and quickly animate this thing, all right? Just to show you guys one thing. I'm going to go ahead and open it down to transform and say scale. I'm going to go ahead and make it really, really small. Oops. Yep. Yeah, somewhere over there. Go ahead in time, use my CTI, that's my current time indicator. If you guys want to follow along, it will be really, really great if you follow along, but I'm just saying, if you don't want to, then don't, fine, I'm cool with it. I'm going to scrub the CTI ahead in time, that is, like, I'm going to go ahead in time. I'm going to keep it somewhere on 10 seconds and 1 frame, I think 1 frame will be good. And then reveal my name, yeah, something like that. It's going to be a pathetic animation, but just to explain to people, I think I'm good with it. Alright guys, so let's take a look at what have we got here, alright? Now, if you people are wondering that how do you play or something, alright, your player animation? Now, I haven't taught you about animation, guys, okay, so don't worry, alright, we will get to that part, don't worry, okay? No need to worry at all, we'll get to that part. But when you people want to play something, okay, like if you have some extra knowledge, or if you have gone ahead and found out something about Adobe After Effects, and if you want to play your composition, you gotta look for this thing right here, okay? It's a preview panel. Now, if you're using the Essentials workspace, alright, I've gone ahead and created my own workspace. But if you're using the standard workspace, the thing is going to be somewhere over here, right? This is the thing. I'm going to switch back to my normal workspace, yeah. And make sure that your CTI is on the, like, on the very first frame, or at least on that part from where you want to start your animation, okay? Or you want to start the playing. And go ahead and click this, the ramp preview. It's going to be the last button, right? Over here. Go ahead and click on that. The ramp preview, people, is supposed to be a playing thing, okay, which basically tells After Effects that After Effects, go ahead and first, you know, you load up all your frames, you do all your calculations, okay, you slowly go ahead and, you know, you first display my thing properly, and then in one shot, you can go ahead and play it properly. Now, you can see this green blue line, or this green color line, which is right here on top of my layers, okay, on top of my layers. This is supposed to be the loading thing for Adobe After Effects. Now, if you see, guys, my animation was only till around 10 seconds, okay. But if you see, this thing is just my CTI, keeps playing, okay? And so that's basically, you know, again and again going and bringing it back from here, right? And then going doing an at-time preview. This is not basically, you know, that much efficient. So what you can do is, wherever you want to stop, okay? And you want to make a loop, all right? Say a loop, all right? A loop is supposed to be a place in your timeline where you want the video to repeat itself, okay? So say I want to create a loop at 10 seconds so that I can, again and again, keep on playing my video. Right from 10 seconds, it comes, my CTI comes to 10 seconds. And it jumps back again to the first frame, alright? So if you want to do that, go to the last frame, okay, where you want your loop to be created, right? I'm going to go to this. I'm going to manually type in my thing, 0, 0, 0, right? Just say 1000. That's 10 seconds. And I'm going to go ahead and press the N key on my keyboard, right? If I press the N key, you'll see that something happened, okay? Something really unusual happened in my timeline. Now, what was that, alright? Let's go and do an undo. Now, if you see this thing right here, alright, this is supposed to be the work area, alright, this thing right here. I'm not talking about the big thing. Actually, that's a movie. I downloaded a movie. Right. Sorry for that. You can see this thing right here, guys, okay, this thing right here, the time ruler, the work area. This is called the work area, okay? And this is the place, guys, where the CTI just keeps on rolling, alright? So, if you want to create a loop, right, I'm going to go and put in a 1000 again, enter. So, what you can do is you can manually go to this end thing, alright, and when it says work area end, you can drag it to the left and create a loop. Or, like I said, you can just go ahead and press the N key on your keyboard and create a loop for yourself. So now what will happen is, if we go ahead and make a ramp preview of it again, it's gonna go, and come on, it's still going. And now take a look at this thing, guys, what happens? It just goes back to the first frame and plays again. So that's what a loop is. And if you want to create that, so make sure that you contract your workspace, alright, to the part where you want to have a loop, right? So that's how you do it. And now what I'm going to come to is, yeah, this part right here. This part right here, guys, okay, this is supposed to be the zooming area of in Adobe After Effects. Now I have, like, the way I teach it, it's like the hills and the big mountains. If the scroller, okay, there's a scroller in the middle. If the scroller people is supposed to be on the left hand side, okay, it's on the hills. Basically, it is contracted, right? And if it's on the big mountain side, okay, you're gonna zoom into the place where your CDI is, okay? So I'm gonna go back and zoom out and say that I want to go ahead and keep it on 5 frames, right? Say 5.03. And then if I zoom in, guys, I'm gonna go ahead and land properly on the place where, yeah, that's it. Place where I wanted, alright. So that's a very important thing. But guys, it's not really like this is not the way of working like a professional to, you know, where you want to zoom in, you use your CTI with your mouse and, you know, then you keep it over here and then you again go down and press on the zoom in button. So what we do is, guys, that we use the keyboard shortcut, okay? For zooming in into the timeline, you use the keyboard shortcut of plus key, alright? Take a look at the plus key, that's where it'll zoom in. And if you take a look at the minus key, if you press the minus key, guys, it's gonna zoom out. So that's how the layers work in Adobe After Effects. And yeah, but before closing the video, guys, the final thing which I want to teach to you guys is going to be the length, okay? Now, if you have seen this video or this composition, you can see that I've got all these different lengths, okay, of my layers, okay? You can see that this layer is so small, then this is a little bigger, this is a little bigger than this. So basically, how do I get them smaller or bigger, okay? So let's have a look at that. Once you have created a layer, okay, go to the end of it, alright, go to the end of it, and when you get this kind of arrow, alright, your mouse pointer just changes to this two-headed arrow, right, click on it, and drag it to the left. If you drag it to the left, people, you're gonna make the length of your layer smaller. Similarly, if you drag it to the right, you're gonna increase the length of your layer, okay, in your time, in your project, alright. So, I'm gonna, stop my video here, alright, thank you so much for watching my video, guys. In the next video, guys, you're gonna take a look at the layer properties, okay, that is scaling your layers, opacity of the layers, rotation, position, and all those different things. Alright, so thank you for watching my video, people. Please subscribe me, like my video, and thank you once again. Thank you. Peace.